In the post-Tagore literary scene, Buddhadev Basu is universally regarded as one of the most original and significant contributors. A poet at heart, his versatile genius was reflected in virtually every form of literature. Now, we shall look into his contribution as prose writer, playwright, translator, and comparatist. Buddhadev, who is most easily one of the most outstanding writers of prose in Bengali, never believed in any false demarcation between the prose of feeling and the prose of thought. In other words, there is no dissociation of sensibility in his writings. His prose can be divided into four categories: novels, short stories, personal essays, and critical writings. Critics have often labeled his prose as poetic, but he himself showed no discontent about this term, because he merrily blurred the distinction between poetry and fiction.
The theme that runs through all of Buddhadev's novels and short stories is the Joycean portrait of an artist. The dichotomy of art and life, the counterpoint between love and death, and the repeated returns to nature to renew the solipsistic attitudes are the leitmotifs of his novels and stories.
Rajani Holo Utala is the first short story of Buddhadev to be published in Kollol in 1926. Contemporary critics like Sajani Kanto Dash could not quite accept the newly adopted sensuousness of the young author, and a woman critic even wished his death. Now, of course, we don't find anything obscene in the story, and it's been duly appreciated for its free-flowing narrative, delving deep into human psychology.
Buddhadev's first collection of short story, Obhinoy, Obhinoy Noy, O Onnanno Golpo, was published in 1930. Even at this early age, he showed maturity in the portrayal of female character. For example, Roma, the female protagonist of the story Obhinoy Noy, is depicted as an enigma incarnate. She is an expert in love play and flirts with the amorous character Pratul. Her character goes through a sea change after she is captivated by the performance of the play Sita by the group of Shishir Bhaduri. The credence of art finally showed the protagonist the beauty of life.
Purana Paltone Prothom Jokhon Gelum Boyoshondhir Probhabe Nijeke Ami Bhishon Dukhe Kalpona Korchi Ebong Roj Duto Tinte Kore Byartho Premer Kobita Likhchi. সংসার সমাজের প্রতি সমস্ত মন তখন বিমুখ, বোহেমিয়ানিজমকে সার করেছে জীবনে।
Later, Buddhadev brilliantly depicted the essence of adolescent love and longing based on his own experience. In the story Amra Tinjon, Bikash, Oshit and Shitangshu, the three musketeers of old Dhaka Polton, who have just passed matriculation, intensely long for the attention of a neighborhood girl. She, however, dies at childbirth. While growing up, the young men secretly cherish the memories of helping and caring for her at the time of her prolonged illness. Such depiction of precious feelings and emotion associated with a kind of pure love marks Buddhadev's early stories.
In the short story Feriwala, in Feriwala Onnanno Golpo, Buddhadev deals with subtle human emotions within a small family.
এক মাস কেটে গেল, কি আশ্চর্য! শান্তনু হঠাৎ একদিন বললে, বুড়ো আর এলোই না? নীলিমা বললে, এলো না তো। কি হলো ওর বলতো? হয়তো দেশে ফিরে গেছে ওর মেয়ের কাছে। কি বলো? হয়তো গেছে, হয়তো গাড়ি চাপা পড়েছে, হয়তো জ্বর হয়ে মরে গেছে, কি হয়তো কলকাতারই অন্য কোনো পাড়ায় ঝাঁঝা রোদ্দুরে পথে পথে ঘুরে গলা ফাটিয়ে চিনি সিঁদুর হেঁকে বেড়াচ্ছে। দেশে যাবার পয়সা জমাতে এখনো ঢের দেরি, কে জানে।
It's in fact the little emotions, follies and crises of the ordinary middle class families and common men that Buddhadev explores with an immaculate craftsmanship in the short stories of his early and middle period. গড়েতে ভ্রমর এলো, প্রেমের বিচিত্র গতি, শ্বেতপত্র, অসামান্য মেয়ে, নতুন নেশা, শনিবারের বিকেল and পথের রাত্রি are stories that kaleidoscopically examine human relationships.
In the collections beginning with Baishe Shrabon, published in 1942, and continuing up to Char Drisho, published in 1955. The author explored the dreamy landscapes of the mind in a poignantly lyrical narration. It is in the stories of Hridoye Jagoron, published in 1961, that the author dispensed with the romantic jealousy and tried to face the reality of life.
What is special, peculiar about Buddhadev Basu is that he had transferred some kind of British English syntax, sentence structure, phrasing in Bangla. For example, shokal cha, shokaler cha. He wouldn't say shokaler cha, shokal cha, rat khabar, dinner bollen na, rat khabar. And he used amply clauses. Shei bari, je barir, jar uthone, jar gacher pechon dike. A kind of construction like this went on and on and on, and I loved it. This, I think, is a special contribution of Buddhadev Basu to Bengali prose style.
In his writings for children and youth, Buddhadev often creates a mixed world of innocence and suspense. The stories are full of humor, originated from intense practical situations. Buddhadev offers his young readers the fundamentals of home life and certain social norms in the stories like Jogaiyer Kando, Ranna Theke Kanna, Calendar Babu, Haran Jatha O Shujitda, etc.
The speciality of Buddhadev Basu is that he did not specially write for the children. What we found in Buddhadev Basu stories was a very human account of life, characters, how children behave and how they can mature up from one kind of experience. And there were lots of stories which were stories of humor, but in a very subtle sense of the term. For example, the story Lekha Ar Khela. It's a wonderful story. If you do not know the technicalities of football, of the game of soccer, you may not be able to take in the entire rasa of the story.
Buddhadev's novels, in keeping with Virginia Woolf's description of the novel as a mixed genre, demonstrate a medley of all the genres. To acquire the unflinching vision of a man who is essentially an artist, he searched for a subjective totality in the light of D.H. Lawrence and Dostoevsky, Tolstoy and Thomas Mann, James Joyce and Rabindranath.
The Kollol poets had to literally revolt against Rabindranath to free their poetry from his influence, and Buddhadev was no exception. But as a novelist, he didn't have any such problem. He found his unique style, his touch, from the very beginning. And this is reflected in the earliest works like Shara and Akurbanno, as early as in 1930.
Shara, or The Response, is the first of Buddhadev's novels, published in 1930. The protagonist is Shagor. His childhood and adolescence are marked by his attachment to his mother, who symbolizes a stable refuge amidst the flux of life. The substitutes, Monimala and Lokhi, fail to satisfy his desires, and Shagor commits suicide. In fact, the vehicle of death is more important to the protagonist than death itself.
Young Buddhadev's vacillation between the spells of art and love is reflected in the novels Jedin Putlo Kamol, Dhushar Gothuli and Ashur Jampasha, all of which were published in 1933.
Along with his Kollolian colleagues, Premendra and Ochinto Kumar, Buddhadev experimented with the idea of writing novels collaboratively. The outcome of that joint effort were two novels, Bishorpil and Bonoshri, both of which incorporate loosely woven tales and unconventional idiom. Buddhadev excelled in portraying the middle-class family in some of his better-known novels, like Kalo Hawa and Tithidor. His analyses of the very different psyches of various family members who live under the same roof are truly commendable. For example, the novel Kalo Hawa, which the author later adapted in the play Maya Maloncho, is a persuasively written account of the slow but inevitable disintegration of a seemingly happy family, the disastrous end involving the death of the father, the insanity of the mother caused by religion, and the elopement of the younger sister are depicted with a suspension of disbelief. The letter of Buli, the younger sister, sums it all.
মা কিছু বলেন না কি রে আমার কথা জানি না আমার বিয়ের কথা বাবা মাকে বলার সময় পেয়েছিলেন কিনা সারাটা দিন বাবা এঘর ওঘর করেছিলেন সেদিন কখন মা আসবেন আমি বুঝতে পারছিলাম এ কথাটা বলবার জন্যই ছটফট করছিলেন মা সারাটা দিনেও ফিরলেন না তারপর থাক তারপরের কথা আর কেন মা হয়তো এখন কিছুই বুঝবেন না তবু এ কথাটা তুই তাকে বলিস
The novel Tithidor is another brilliant effort by the author. Critics have described it as an excellent middle-class family portrait. In the end, the novel almost becomes poetry with Buddhadev's unique stream of consciousness treatment.
চোখ নেই, চোখ খোলা, খোলা জানালা কালো, বাইরে কালো, কালো আকাশে তারা, দূরে, পারে, পরপারে, হয়ে যাওয়া, না হওয়া, হতে থাকা চিরকালের আকাশ ভরা স্তব্ধ তারা তাকিয়ে থাকল
Tithidor was his most popular novel and we had all read it in our adolescence but later on I read some of his other novels one of which was amazing Onno Konkhane there he has narrated his whole journey from Noakhali to Dhaka from Dhaka to Kolkata and here in the end He has used the stream of consciousness style exactly in the same way he has used it in the last portion of Tithidor. And I think it's so commendable, the use of stream of consciousness.
For Buddhadev, the artist is only to be judged by his freedom in his range of choices. Molinath, in 1952, a partially autobiographical novel, according to the author, is the most subtle version of this postulate. Buddhadev commented that in Molinath he depicted a man who had tried very hard all his life and at great cost, making personal sacrifices to become a total artist.
Buddhadev remained, in some ways, a misunderstood author. In 1969, he was charged with obscenity for his epistolary novel Radhpure Brishti, the experimental quality of which was largely unappreciated.
Buddhadev's other novel, like Nilanjoner Khata and Patal Theke Ala, again portray the predicaments of a true artist in his lone quest. The very title of the second book reminds one of Dostoevsky's Notes from Underground. Ainar Moddhe Eka and Golap Keno Kalo once more intensify the issue of the asociality of art and estrangement of the artist, who delights in being a misfit in society for a definite cause.
Buddhadev was influenced by Sanskrit poetry, especially Kalidas, whose Meghaduta he translated. And for this translation, he sort of fabricated a meter which resembled the Mandakranta as far as Bengali verse could offer.
Kamero udrek je kore shei meghe, sahosa dekhe tar shamukhe. যক্ষ কোনো মতে চোখের জল চেপে ভাবলে মনে মনে বহুক্ষণ নবীন মেঘ দেখে মিলিত সুখী জন তারাও হয়ে যায় অন্য মোনা কি আর কথা তবে যদি সে দূরে থাকে যে চায় কণ্ঠের আলিঙ্গন
বুদ্ধদেব কালিদাস ইজ নাইদার লাইক দ্বিজেন্দ্রনাথ ঠাকুর নর রাজশেখর বসুজ ওয়ার্কস অন দ্য সেম সাবজেক্ট Buddhadev wanted Sanskrit literature to break free from the complex Hindu philosophy and idealism and endeavour to rediscover it purely from the literary angle. Interestingly, Buddhadev handled the Sanskrit meter Mandakranta as skillfully as Rabindranath or Shutendranath Dotto, with the breath pause permitted in the Bengali tongue. In Uttar Megh, the Sanskrit poet seems to be more mature than in Purva Megh, and so is his Bengali translator.
Buddhadev's reinterpretations of foreign poetry are evidence of the poet's self-renewal. Especially in the last phase of his poetic career, Buddhadev suffered from a kind of stagnation. It was at this time that he continued his creative journey, by translating poetry of select foreign poets. Thus, in addition to Baudelaire and Rilke, he translated Helderlin, Ezra Pound, E.E. Cummings, Wallace Stevens, and Boris Pasternak. These are unified, conscious attempts to deepen and widen the nuances of the receptor language by wiping out its limitations.
প্রত্যেকটি অনুবাদ গ্রন্থের সঙ্গে পাস্টেরনাক আলাদা গ্রন্থ হিসেবে বেরোয়নি, কিন্তু একটা প্রবন্ধ ছিল বরিস পাস্টেরনাক বিষয়ে। কিন্তু মেঘদূত, শালবোদ্দের, হেডলিন এবং রুলকে এদের চারজনের এই চারটি অনুবাদের সঙ্গে দীর্ঘ ভূমিকা। সংস্কৃত কবিতা নিয়ে, আধুনিক যুগ নিয়ে দীর্ঘ ভূমিকা লেখেন, বোদলিয়ান নিয়ে, মানে এই ভূমিকাগুলো এখন আমরা বলি ক্লাসিক।
থ্রু হিজ ট্রান্সলেশন, পোয়েটস লাইক বোদলিয়ার, রিলকে অর হেলডেলিন সিজড টু বি পোয়েটস অফ ডিস্টেন্ট ল্যান্ডস অ্যান্ড বিকেম আওয়ার ওন পোয়েটস। Thus, as a comparatist, Buddhadev not only enriched his students and scholars, but also successfully dissipated the essence of foreign literature among the common readers.
কাজ যতক্ষণ ততক্ষণ একটা অস্তিত্বহীনতা, যে মুহূর্তে তা শেষ হলো সে মুহূর্তে নিজের জীবন, আমার নিজের জীবন, অবসরের সময়টা আমার, সেটুকু সময় আমি বাঁচব। তখন রাত্রির ক্লাইভ স্ট্রিটের ছায়ালোক, হৃদয়ে চাঁদের স্পর্শ।
In his personal essays, Buddhadev Basu is in perpetual search for a sensibility which eludes philosophical generalization. In the essays, it is initially the style which sets the matter going and brings a cluster of associations which are often poetic. Starting from his Hotat Alur Chalkani, 1935, through the critical sketches of Khalid Putul, 1946, to the travelogue Japani Journal, 1961, the author tends to show how nimble and multifaceted prose can be. He tags along the reader with him. These qualities are evident in the famous essays like Uttor Tirish, Boro Rasta, Choto Flat, Blackout, Professor, Kothao Gothok, Daghor, Adda, Shopche Dukhe Dughanta, etc. In a lighter vein, Buddhadev also tried his hand in Romo Rochona, which was equally fascinating and which wove a pattern of fascination in his own way.
Buddhadev Basu te ami dekhlam je khabarer bornona ebong dresser bornona bishesh kore khabarer bornona eto rokom eto chomotkar je jinish chokher samne pheshe uthe আর সবচেয়ে মজার কথা হচ্ছে, আমি বুদ্ধদেবের কাছে যাবার আগে বলি যে এখন বিজ্ঞাপনের ভাষায় বা ওই প্রত্যেক পত্রিকাতে হয়েছে না যে বিভিন্ন হোটেলের মেনু টেনু নিয়ে লেখা, সমস্ত বুদ্ধদেব থেকে নেওয়া, সমস্ত একদম ইনফ্লুয়েন্স বাই বুদ্ধদেব বসু। তো ওর যে বর্ণনা, লালচে ঝোলের মধ্যে গোলাপি গোলাপি কাঁকড়া শুয়ে আছে, আচ্ছা, কিংবা ফুলকপির বালিশে মাথা দিয়ে কুচকুচে কালো কই মাছ। তো এই যে খাবারের বর্ণনা, এটা কিন্তু ভীষণ বাংলা সাহিত্য এবং বাংলা বিজ্ঞাপন জগৎকে ভীষণ প্রভাবান্বিত করেছে।
From the mid-60s, Buddhadev excelled in verse drama and remains till date the most important author of the genre since Tagore.
Many of Buddhadev's poetic plays or verse plays are remarkable. Toposhi o Torongini, which is reminiscent of Rabindranath's Chandalika, shows brilliant dramatic quality. It revolves around Buddhadev's favorite theme, the descent of the so-called perfect character to the follies of life. The background of famine, village women, the exalted moment of the first exchange of glances between the boyish mendicant and the sophisticated prostitute, Buddhadev's imagination captured all these elements. Buddhadev was always fascinated by Indian epics, especially the Mahabharata. The universal cycle of life and death, reflected in various chapters of the Mahabharata, incited Buddhadev's creative spirit to incorporate that philosophy into his writings. This led to the stupendous critical account, Mahabharata's Katha, and a few poetic plays grounded in the major characters and incidents of the Mahabharata. These plays are Anamni Angona, Prothom Partho, Shankranti, and Kalushondha.
In the first part of Prothom Partho, the dramatic conversation between Karna and Kunti is comparable to Rabindranath's treatment of the same subject in the poem Karna Kunti Sangat. While Rabindranath stresses the emotional aspects of the characters, Buddhadev's discourse addresses the quintessential questions of life. This is evident from the confessions of Karna to Draupadi.
Tumi jeno, ami Duryodhaner jantra noi. Keu mitra noy amar. Kauke ami shotru bole bhabi na. Ami shadhin. Ami nishshongo.
In Kalushondha, Buddhadev depicts the tragic fall of the great warrior Arjuna and his mentor Krishna, who is a personification of God. With this play, Buddhadev affirms his realization that as human being, we should not be obsessed with the fear of death. Instead, we must realize that we are part of an endless flow of time.
উত্তত হও কিরঙ্কিত বাহু
তোরা করো সন্ধ্যা নামে
সন্ধ্যা এত দ্রুত কেন সন্ধ্যা
আসন্ন সময়
আসন্ন সময়
আসন্ন সময়
আসন্ন সময়
আসন্ন সময়
আরে তো সুন্দর যেন রুগ্ন শান্তিহীন
পার্থ সব্যসাচী অর্জুন
But enthralled as we are with his verse drama, it must be acknowledged that he wrote equally fascinating plays in prose, which have captivated the theatre audience all these years. One can think of Pata Jore Jai, Babu O Bibi, Punor Milan, Shotto Shando, Kolkata Electra, etc.
Deshputrikar jonne uni Mahabharater kotha likhte arambho korlen. Mone mone bujhte perechilen or ar shomoy nei. Kaje atokhon Kolkata shohore bidyut paoa jay na. Choto 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 mombati eituku mombati paoa jeto na. সরু সরু সেই এক গাদা মোমবাতি সাজিয়ে সেগুলো সেই আলোতে বসে লিখতেন কিন্তু সারাদিন লিখতেন বসে আর রাত্রিরেও লিখতেন এই করে লিখতে লিখতে তখন আমি অমিয় এবং সুবীর রায় চৌধুরী তিনজনে মিলে প্রুফ দেখেছি বারবার বারবার প্রুফ দেখে ওকে পাঠিয়ে দিতাম আবার উনি সেগুলো সংশোধন করে এখানে পাঠাতেন
আমি বলছি যে ওর এই তুলনামূলক সাহিত্য পদ্ধতির প্রকৃষ্ট প্রয়োগ হচ্ছে এই মহাভারতের কথাতে উনি অর্জুন যুধিষ্ঠিরকে নিয়ে যে তর্ক সেই তর্কটা ধীরে ধীরে তৈরি করছেন যে গ্যথের ছিল ঐশ্বর্যের দারিদ্র গ্যথে এত বিপুল ছিলেন এত লিখেছেন এত জিনিস লিখেছেন এত জিনিস করেছেন যেটা ছিল ঐশ্বর্যের দারিদ্র পভার্টি অফ রিচেস আর হেল্ডলিন ওই কয়েকটা কবিতা লিখেছেন একটা উপন্যাস লিখেছেন আর বিশেষ কিছু করেননি হেল্ডলিনের ছিল দারিদ্রের ঐশ্বর্য এটা বুদ্ধদেব বসু মহাভারতের কথাতে অর্জুন এবং যুধিষ্ঠির প্রসঙ্গে ব্যবহার করছেন অর্জুনের ছিল ঐশ্বর্যের দারিদ্র আর যুধিষ্ঠির ছিল দারিদ্রের ঐশ্বর্য রাজশেখর বসু বলেছিলেন যুধিষ্ঠিরের কথা বুদ্ধদেব বসুর প্রতিপাদ্য হচ্ছে যুধিষ্ঠির
একদিন আমি এখানে খেতে বসেছি রাত্রিরে হঠাৎ শোনা গেল অমিয় টেলিফোন করলো স্ট্রোক হয়েছে সুনীল শক্তি এরা কত লোক এরা সব গেছেন আমি পারিনি যেতে আমি দেখতে পারিনি
Buddhadev Basu passed away in 1974. Almost all the contemporary writers and poets paid homage to this versatile genius during his last journey. Some of them even carried his hearse.
In 2008, the Indian Postal Department commemorated the centenary of Buddhadev's birth by publishing a stamp with his portrait. In the same year, Jadavpur University dedicated a seminar hall in his name, paying tribute to one of the renowned founder professors of the institution.
হাওয়ার শব্দ নেই
হাজারিবাগের ভোরের গন্ধ নেই
হা বুলবুলুর গায়ের গন্ধ নেই
মেহজানের জলের গন্ধ নেই
রায়গঞ্জের ঘাসের গন্ধ নেই
মনে হয় আমরা কখনো বাঁচিনি
বেঁচে আছি আমরা বেঁচে আছি